What stands out to you about the last chapter of your book?
The last chapter of the book is very unique. It's very special. I won't get into too much about it. But the reason that it was special is because I was no longer at the computer. I was going to bed, and it was almost midnight. And voices saying, get a lot of paper, a lot of paper. So I went and got a lot of paper and a pen. And I'm tired. I want to go to bed. And all of a sudden, I'm writing by hand. Everything is coming, writing and writing and writing, all this page after page after page. And I fell asleep and just set the papers down, woke up, and I'm still writing. And it was Acar communicating with me. It was spirit. It was like talking to God. And it was telling me what's happening in the world today, what the dark energy is, what the fears are, what the hope is. And it was absolutely
awesome.
I knew my purpose in life. I knew where I was in my spiritual journey. I knew what had to change. But there's a lot about the world and that's written in that last chapter. So it was special. But my vibration changed, and I was more receptive or something there was something about having to do it by hand, and so that's why that was so special.
From an astrologer's perspective, can you share your take on what's happening in the world today, and how does the end of 2012 look for the world?
Yeah, the end of 2012, that really got a lot of attention from people. End of July or August, depending on it. It's around the middle of July, but it's July and August. Mars is going to go into Libra, and when it does, it'll hit Pluto, and it'll hit Uranus, those signs. And there's something, there's a threat, and it's global. And it only lasts a week or two. I mean, it doesn't last very long, 3 weeks at the most, maybe. But it's scary. Whatever's happening is it's almost like the whip of the dragon's tail, one last hit to make your adjustments, and one of the last things to scare you when it blows fire. But right after that, things settle down, and, you know, a little tidbit of planets maybe towards Christmas. But then it stops. Saturn goes into Scorpio in October. It makes sextiles to Pluto, I think it is, and trines to Neptune and Pisces. And that's favorable. That's us relaxing. That's not us being on guard anymore. While we're on guard, we can't see the solutions. We're tense. We're afraid. We've been beat up. But when we relax, then the good things happen. And so the good is happening. The whole vibration is changing because the battleships of these planets and the aspects they made, they're falling apart. They're now waving to each other in the harbor rather than guns at each other affecting everybody's lives. So, but the marker of time is close to the same time. So there will be something that comes along where we either see good results of some of the things that have been put in place or something new comes along. So I have great hope.